First of all, I'm delighted to be here on the occasion of this very unique study. And let me first congratulate Young Lives for this very, very comprehensive study. It's important that, you know, it's an issue which has been of great concern to us, that we've been talking about India's growth while we are growing at about 7.5%, and our ambition is to grow at higher rates. My belief all along has been that it will not be possible for India to grow rapidly till we don't focus on, first of all, nutrition. It's not possible for India to grow rapidly if 33% of the stunted children across the world are in India. It's just not feasible. You're losing out the whole demographic advantage. And it's not possible if your 40%, 42% of your children in class 5 are not able to read their mother tongue of class 2. And this is not just one study by ESSER, but NAS study across several studies which is coming out. That while we've been able to provide access of education, the quality of learning has radically fallen. And therefore, this particular analysis of the fifth round of the longitudinal study with 3,000 children in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, with two cohorts, round 5, 22-year-old, older cohort born between 94 and 95, and 15-year-old younger cohort born 2001 and 2. I think is a very unique study because Young Lives findings, actually study centers across their Peru, Vietnam, Ethiopia and India are to be shared. And to my mind, you know, the chief features of this research component in the study, you know, the quantitative research with 5 survey rounds of all 3,000 children, their caregivers and community leaders. And then the qualitative research with in-depth interviews with a small group of 48 children, their peers and parents, and 2 school surveys, that is primary and secondary, conducted in private and government schools. And this is a very, very comprehensive, very in-depth, very comprehensive, very detailed study. And this brings out very sharp lessons for all of us. Now, the Government of India has also mapped its schemes and outcome-based measurements to SDGs. And longitudinal studies like this are truly invaluable for us to assess and to reassess what to measure at a national scale and to understand the issues our policies have to address. Since this study measures the foundational causes of poverty that children grow up with, it also gives us in many ways the tools to unlock wealth for them. And I think it's very, very important because I've been a long-term believer in outcome-based measurement. My belief is that unless and until we don't have real-time data where you can compare the performance of one district with another district or one taluk with another taluk, it will not be possible. So when I came to Niti Aayog, the first thing I did was that we start putting real-time data. You know, unless you don't have real-time data, you will never be able to work. One is real-time data on health, education and water management, which to my mind is a very complex issue and which will be one of our biggest challenges. And studies like this are important, but studies like this must be put out in public domain. People must know, and then only good governance will become good politics. And therefore, just 3 things. One is real-time data, very close monitoring, ranking, putting it in public domain holds the key to my mind. So I'm particularly delighted that this is a very unique study by Young Lives. Very detailed presentation has been made, and I think this presentation should be made again because the key preliminary findings on all these aspects, education and learning, on poverty and intergenerational change, on youth transitions, on several aspects, they are very, very skill work and even family formation. I found this of great importance because we in Niti Aayog are laying, our belief is, and our, you know, our total belief is that this country can't grow rapidly, this country can't be transformed till there's, we don't lay emphasis on nutrition, health and education. And I was quite amazed actually, almost 41% of the children are not able to do subtraction and addition in Kerala. So the basic foundation is not there, and it's not that there are no teachers. There are teachers, but they're not going to rural areas. So the whole process of selection has gone wrong somewhere. It's not that there are no doctors. Doctors are all packed in Patna. They're not going to rural areas. So there's something seriously wrong with the process of governance, and I think there's several good lessons to be learned. There are very unique good practices. I mean, Haryana has done this process of selection where they went through this whole process of selection where they gave three choices to the teachers. All computerized based selection. 97% of the people selected went to the place where they wanted to go, and they will remain there. So it's process, it's, there's a lot of good learnings from one another that we can learn within this country, and huge lessons in nutrition. I mean, the massive lessons in nutrition which we can learn from each other. We need to ensure that education, health, nutrition reaches the scheduled tribes. This, to my mind, is very critical. And I have a, my concern is also that access to safe drinking water is also a very critical factor. But, you know, somehow I seem, my analysis seems to show that, you know, poverty and education and health is also directly correlated to connectivity. Our analysis shows that where we've been able to provide access and connectivity, roads and electricity, there's been a general upliftment. And therefore, infrastructure, physical infrastructure of connectivity and electricity becomes very critical. Sanitation will, over a period of time, to my mind, will be a very critical role. It will have a huge impact on improvement of nutrition. And therefore, my view is that this is a very, very unique study by Young Lives. I greatly appreciate the work done. We in Niti Aayog will very closely examine this, and we'll try and take this further to learn the lessons from this and see how best we can make policy changes based on this study. My compliments to all of you, Dr. Renu, to Joy Borden and Young Lives for this very unique study. It's a very comprehensive, very professional, very in-depth study which brings out real data till now. And this will greatly benefit all of us in Niti Aayog. Thank you very much. Greatly appreciate it.